In the tablet wireframes, when a list item is selected, it shows this blue activated state background. This can be done by setting the background of the list item to be a state drawable. We can look at the documentation for the stateless drawable, which is linked below. Essentially, a stateless drawable allows you to specify different drawables based on the state of the view. We provide you the code for the stateless drawable. Drop it in by creating a drawable folder under the res directory. When set as the background of a list item, we see that the background is just transparent by default, such as this today layout here. When the view is pressed, then we see a gray background. When the view is activated, then we see this blue color. This is also indicating that it's the selected item in the two-pane mode. We also have a second version of the touch selector file for lollipop devices and above. This is saved in the drawable V21 folder, so that on platforms API level 21 and above, it will use this version of the touch selector. On older devices, it will fall back to the touch selector in the base drawable folder. One of the main principles of material design is responsive interaction. One way to accomplish this is that when a user touches the device will acknowledge the interaction and a ripple will radiate out from the touch point. This is done with a ripple drawable. You can add a ripple element in your stateless drawable XML. For the V21 touch selector, it's the same except that for the press state, we have a ripple drawable with a gray color for touch feedback. And on a lollipop device, you can see the ripple. In the list item layout, we set the background to be this touch selector. We do the same for the list item forecast today layout. Back in the touch selector file, I want to note that there are some colors here. The @Android color notation is for a framework defined color. The other colors are ones that we defined in the colors.xml file. This file is located in the values folder of your app. It's useful to store colors in a central location if you need to reference colors multiple times in your app. As a hint, to make a list item show its activated state, you can look at the documentation for the XML attribute choice mode for the list view. Once you find the right attribute, you'll realize that you want different behavior for one pane versus two pane mode. While you could change the behavior programmatically in the Java code, we'd like you to do it purely via the resource XML files using a style. Read this doc to learn about how styles can be defined in XML, and use what you learned earlier about defining alternative resources for different size devices. In general, styles are a way that you can group together attributes for a view. For example, these text attributes are replaced by this style, code font. The code font style is defined in the styles.xml file located in the values folder. You can also have styles inherit other styles by specifying the parent. There are a couple of other examples you can check out on this page. This is what the app should look like when you're done. In one pane mode, we don't see the activated state, but there is still the regular press state with the ripple, and then it goes away.